Hi there, this is HackRich. So in this video, we are going to discuss how to enumerate and exploit NFS services. So let's get started. NFS is a distributed file system protocol. Using NFS, server can share all or portion of the file system on a network server. So that can be accessible by the user present on a remote machine who has the right permission to access it. Let's check whether our server enables NFS service or not. For that, let's use nmap sudo nmap-p to specify the port number. Here, NFS uses the default port number 2049. So I will specify the default port number and the IP address of the server 10.0.2.9. So here, if you look at the result, state is open. That means our server enables NFS service, right? So let's check what are the file system are shared through this NFS service. For that, we can use showmount command utility, showmount hyphen e IP address of the server. So here, this is the file system which is shared through NFS service. And this asterisk symbol means that any machine can mount this file system. So sometime you will see IP address or a list of IP address in place of this asterisk symbol. That means only that specific IP machine can mount this file system. So in our case, anyone can mount this file system. So let's mount it to our local machine. Before that, let's create a separate directory for that. Let's hop over to temp folder, temp make dir. Let's call it as well. And let's mount that file system to this folder. Mount, it needs a root privilege. Mount, hyphen t to specify the type of the file system, which is NFS, and IP address of the server, and file system which you want to mount, which is home, Volnix, and where you want to mount them, and Vol. Hit enter. So this is the directory. So if I try to traverse to that directory, I will get the permission denied error. So that is because once the file system is mounted to our local machine, only protection or security that NFS provides is based on user ID. So if two users hold the same user ID, then one user can access the resource of other user. So here, if I check my user ID, it is 1000. This one directory is owned by the user who has the user ID 2008, but my user ID or this MSF admin user ID is 1000. So that is why I cannot access this one directory. So here, if you look at the permission, read, write, execute for the owner of this directory and read and execute for the group and no other permission for others, right? So that is why we are getting the permission denied error. In order to access this one directory, as I said, if two user has the same user ID, then one user can access the resource of other user, right? So let's create a new user with a user ID 2008. Then we are able to access this one directory. So clear this out. So another thing is every time we are not get to know that what is the user ID of this directory owner. Now we are able to see that it displays the user ID. Sometime it will not display the user ID. There is some protection for this. I will talk about this in the end of the video. Because we know the user ID, let's create the new user with this user ID. So sudo add user, user ID is 2008, and I will name the user as Volnix. Give the password and retype the password. Let's clear this out and let's switch to that Volnix user. Switch user Volnix. Now the password. That's fine as I. So you can see that owner of this directory is Volnix. Sorry. Okay, let's hop over to one directory as well. So now we are able to see the content present in this directory, right? So we can create a new file or we can edit the file that will be reflected to remote file system as well. But still we don't have a remote access to server, right? We can get the remote access if the server enables the SSH service as well. So SSH protocol is used to get the secure remote shell. There are two ways to log into SSH. One is using password. Another one is using private key. So if you don't know how private key authentication works, go and research on it. So we are going to take advantage of that private key authentication. So here we will create a new two keys. One is public key and private key. And we will drop the public key into this file system. And we will going to use the private key to log into the server. So let's do that. To create a new SSH key pair, you can use SSH keygen. So it will ask where to save that key. So you just hit enter. Hit enter. So if I see, so it will create a new .ssh folder. I hop over to dot folder. So there are two key. This is private key and this is public key. So we will drop this public key to remote file system and we will use this private key to log into the server. So if I say ls minus al, here you can see that .ssh folder is already present. So in your case, there might not be .ssh folder. In that case, you have to create it a .ssh folder by your own using makedir command. So let's go to that .ssh folder. And now we want to copy that newly generated public key to this folder. So let's copy that. Wellnix folder. Public key. And we want to rename it as authorized key. Authorized. So now if I say ls minus. So now let's log into server using this private key. So SSH minus I to specify the private key. ID RSA. And username is Wellnix. And IP address of the server, which is 10.0.29. Yeah, we successfully logged into remote server as a Wellnix user. So this is how we can exploit the NFS service. And coming to NFS protection, if you look at the configuration file of NFS service, sudo edit sudo slash etc slash export. So if you look at here, root squash protection is disabled. So what exactly this root squash protection does is, think about this. As I said, if a two user shares the same user ID, then one user can access the resource of other user. So what happens in case of root user? Because root users shares the same user ID across the Linux and Unix, right? So it cannot distinguish local root user and remote root user. So when we enable the root squash protection, it will treat the local root user as a nobody user. So nobody user is a less privileged user in the system. There are many protection in NFS. You can go through link in the description. You can read more about it. So that is all for this video. Until then, stay tuned, like the video and subscribe the channel. Thank you.